Hi, everybody. It's the Magical Main Street Dads. I'm Josh.
I'm Nevin.
And today, it marks a milestone for us. This is episode number 50!
Woo!
We turned a big 5-0 today. Not really, but we, episode-wise, we will. So, like to thank everybody for their support and following us on all the social media that we have out there. We really do truly appreciate it. So, number 50.
Yeah.
So, about a year in on this, right?
About it, yeah. Yeah, about a year in.
About a year in. This started out as something that Nevin and I wanted to do after watching so many other people do this and have fun doing it. And that's what we're doing, is having fun. And we're having fun with you, our supportive fans out there. So again, we appreciate that. Hope you're having fun along with us. So here's to 50 more episodes.
There you go.
Right. So today we're going to talk about some news that has popped up in Walt Disney World and Disneyland and things like that. But before we get into the big controversial, I would say, topic, we got good news. We have good news.
We have good news.
For those of you that like the buffets or the buffets, the Boma flavors reopened this past week.
Yep.
At Animal Kingdom Lodge as a full buffet, and opening on the 29th of August is the Beer Garden at the Germany Pavilion. Going back, it's open but family style, but going back to buffet.
Yeah.
And I think that's going to help with the atmosphere at that.
You know, at family style, though, at that location, it could work as well.
It could.
It could work as well. It's just the atmosphere, like you're in the German village during Oktoberfest.
Yeah, and I think when by opening up the buffets, it helps with their staffing issues.
Yeah.
Too. So instead of having someone having to come bring you the food and clear the plates and bring you drinks, you go up and you get your stuff, and it alleviates a little bit there.
Right.
Also, a big one that's opening at Magic Kingdom, which has one of my favorite characters. What's wrong with you, man? How can you not like Winnie the Pooh?
I didn't say I did not like Winnie the Pooh.
Oh, yeah, you did.
I never did that. I did not like Winnie the Pooh.
I like your expressions when you just roll your eyes.
Because there's so many better characters out there than Winnie the Pooh. And I'm going to get crucified because my daughter absolutely loves him as well.
That's why I like bringing it up.
There's so many better characters out there than Pooh Bear. Anybody with the name of Pooh? Just saying.
Hey. All right. Well, anyway. Crystal Palace is reopening. Full buffet.
Yep.
I think it's, I don't know why they're doing it, but they are, and enjoy it. Be safe and enjoy it. So I'm not sure if they're putting any extra sneeze guards up or anything, or
I hope so.
How they're doing handling utensils after someone else wiped their nose and touched it, but up to you. I like Crystal Palace, so. When I was going earlier on, I thought it was a great place to go, especially for kids. It's a great place. So maybe I don't know what they're doing with the characters there. So I assume they're coming back. Maybe not giving hugs and things like that, but maybe a train walkthrough or something. So they do it at other places. So that's good news, though.
I got even better news.
Oh, go.
A better restaurant. Ohana is going back to their original menu.
Nice.
They've listened to the cries of the people. For those of you who don't know, Ohana's at the Polynesian Resort, and it's a meet and greet for breakfast. Where I don't know if Lilo and Stitch is going to stay there, or they might switch to Moana since, you know, the conversion of the update. But the food there is phenomenal. It's all around phenomenal food.
See, good things coming out about the restaurants.
Yes.
I like to hear that. I definitely do. Got any other news for the week?
I did see a report on Splash Mountain.
Okay.
And I think this is due to COVID that they're now saying the conversion to the Princess and the Frog is going to take several years to do this. Wow. Yeah. And this is coming from Imagineering Department. And I think it's due to COVID, you know, from the loss of revenue. That the upgrades that they want to do, like I said, I'm curious to see, because they wanted to be all lit up with fireflies because you're supposed to be on the bayou. I want to see how that works. So it's going to be interesting, but they say it's going to take years for it to do. Plus, I mean, let's, political aside, Splash Mountain is one of the big rides, okay? If you take that away during the 50th, that's a main attraction out. And I didn't see them doing that, especially, you know, when they're not up and running with everything open yet. But so Splash Mountain, it's going to take a few years. So all the people that don't want to see it get changed, don't worry, you had time to see it. And for all the people like me who really don't care or is interested to see it, it's going to take a few years. And for all the people that are, oh, it's got to be changed, relax, they're going to change it. It's going to take time because money's short.
Yeah, and it has started. There's scaffolding on the backside of the mountain, yeah. So they're doing things. You said they're not going to take this right away because that increases queue lines for other things. So every ride you take away increases something else, right. Especially in that particular area. People see that's closed. Oh, I'll go on Big Thunder, or I'll hoof it down to Pirates or something. Yeah, so good. Hopefully they keep it running until they have to absolutely shut it down, yeah. After the 50th, do the inside work. And I expect that to take months and months to do. That even, I would maybe even think 9 months to get all that done.
And the thing is, if you think about it, most of the animatronics in there are very old. They're from that, what was it, Songs of America attraction they had. They're old animatronics that need to be refurbished.
Yeah. So
it's not like, oh, okay, we're just going to put new costume on these animatronics and call it a day. These things are old. They're about 20 to 30 years old. They're going to need to be completely refurbished.
Yeah, they got better technology now to
update.
Make it more realistic. So we'll see what they do there.
Yeah. The Tron roller coaster is coming along phenomenally.
Yes, that looks awesome.
Yeah. For those of you who have not seen it, I would recommend going on YouTube. Yeah, granted, it's not in English, but you get the gist of the ride.
It's awesome.
Yeah. I would love to see another Pirates of the Caribbean thrown in there, but the Shanghai version where it's all about Davy Jones. I don't know, if another thing, if you haven't seen it, check it out on YouTube. Yeah, you can't understand what they're saying, but look at the backgrounds and the sceneries. It's almost like you go underwater. You're with Davy Jones and his little Shanghai crew, and it's really neat.
It is pretty cool. Definitely a good watch. All right, cool.
So that's the good news.
Yeah, the good news. So we're going to start discussing, and this is going to be the gist of our episode today. The news this week that FastPass, MaxPass, whatever pass that you were using before in America, it will be no longer coming this fall. And They are introducing a new integration into the My Disney Experience app and the Disneyland app. Now, part of it is free. It's called Genie, Disney Genie. And that in and of itself is something that Disney says that they listen to the feedback of the fans, of the guests, and it's all about making your planning easier, more flexible, and you're going to have a better tool to do this.
I don't know. They didn't call me. I don't know. I want to know who they listened to.
I want to know how many people, were they reading Disney Facebook pages, listening to people gripe and complain about things? Were they listening to people at the parks? Who knows? I don't know who these people are.
Yeah.
Look, everybody's going to have a problem with something, right? Nobody's got not. You can't please everybody. I understand that. We're grown men. We understand you can't please everybody.
Yeah.
However, I don't know if it was a minority voice that they listened to, because I read these groups. I'm in these Facebook groups, and I don't know. I see a lot of people honestly ticked off about this change. So you're going to have the Disney Genie app, and some of it looks okay to me as far as, all right, it can help you plan out things. Maybe it'll map things out easier for you. You can set up an itinerary. I get that. They said that they made significant investments to do this for us in order to reduce the wait times, to find the magic, which, according to so many people, the magic hasn't been taken away. We've even said that. The magic is there. You don't have to search for it. But they're telling us now, we're going to make it easier for you to find the magic, which to me is an admission that you might have taken some magic away from us. I don't know.
What magic are they looking for? The magic to my wallet? Because, I mean, the minute I tell my grandkids, hey, we're flying to Disney, their faces light up. That, to me, is the magic.
Yes. Yes.
I mean, I don't know what magic they're talking, that pry open my checking account magic. That's just it for me.
Well, this is part of, like, and the other thing they want to do is help take the guess and the guessing out of what's next to do for your day. Okay, I don't know about you guys, but we all know that Disney is planning, and even more planning. We plan a year in advance. We pick our dining reservations in advance. You pick your fast passes in advance. You're planning your whole day. A lot of people think that has turned into something of like a fun thing to do. It stresses me out sometimes, but I love doing it. And I love getting everything. Now I'm going to go to this park this day. I look at the calendars. I check out what rides haven't I done, or what do I really got to do? What experiences do I want to do? What shows do I want to do? Make time for a parade. I love that. Okay. So this is going to make it easier to do that somehow. But what I think a lot of people are getting upset about is the Genie Plus aspect of this. Okay. Before I get into that, Genie Plus is the Genie itself. It's basically, you tell Genie what you want to do for today, we'll plan it for you. So it's wake up that morning more spontaneous. I want to hit these rides, I want to hit these experiences, and it's supposed to map it out for you and make your day easier. And as the day progresses, say something changes, wait times, a show gets canceled, a parade, there's inclement weather, the app maybe sends you an alert, I don't know. It changes and it says, hey, you know what, you wanted to go, this is the thing that I'm kind of, I don't like. Say you wanted to hit Buzz Lightyear and you had every other ride done and you're heading over to Buzz Lightyear, and all of a sudden it pops up. Oh, Buzz Lightyear, the wait's a little bit longer than expected. We think you should do this.
Yeah.
Now you're making up my mind for me. Because maybe that wait time is acceptable for me. Still.
Maybe there's going to be a filter where you can put in there a 40-minute wait time is acceptable. You know what I mean? There might be filters. So to me...
I don't know. That's a lot, though.
Yeah. The Genie almost is going to be like Alexa.
Yes.
People who are hooked on the Alexa tool. My thing is, there's certain times of the day where I'm going and, you know, out of the blue, oh, there's no line here for Country Bear Jamboree. Let me go in there and watch it.
Yeah.
I like to plan things, but I also like some spontaneity, too.
Yeah, I mean, I guess you could still do that, but it also makes me think, like, you're best sticking to this plan. And I think that's going to streamline some people. Maybe that's what Disney wants. They want to kind of corral you without being thinking you're being corralled. Right. They're saying, hey, this is the best thing for you today. And for what I saw, I watched the two videos that Disney themselves put out. And so far, all it says on the on the app is it says shorter than normal wait time, or wait time may be longer than normal, average wait time. Well, what time is that? Are they? Hopefully they put the times in there in the Genie app, because I don't want to have to go and flip through the app to MDE and say, oh, it's so average wait is what, an hour? That's still too long for some people.
God, yeah.
So, or is it an hour and a half? So Splash Mountain normal wait times, an hour and a half, 75 minutes. First time goers are not going to know that. And they're going to go, oh, it's an average wait time. That's not bad. They just wasted an hour and 15 minutes of their day because they're stuck in line and didn't understand. I hope they put the actual wait time in there. Don't give me average. Don't give me less than normal. I want to know what the wait time is. Tell me it's less than normal with a 20-minute wait.
I would hope they would, because our local news company has an app for traffic, for accidents and all that stuff that I had from when I worked where I used to work, because we all know how the highways here are. They will tell you, hey, there's an accident on this highway. You know, it'll put an extra 40 minutes on your commute. So if they're able to do something like that, I'm more than positive Disney, being technically savvy, should be able to incorporate the wait, or even maybe hyperlink. You know what I mean? Boom, here, Splash Mountain is a wait. You click on the link, and it takes you to the wait time.
Yeah, I hope they do that.
It would make sense.
It would. It really would. So the app isn't fully out, so I'm just hoping that they do that. As far as personalizing your itinerary for the day, it's not just the rides, but say you want to meet a character. You can go in ahead of time and say for Magic Kingdom that day, you want princesses, Peter Pan, you want to go on a Peter Pan ride, you want to hit Space Mountain, Buzz Lightyear, Big Thunder, Pirates, and Jungle Cruise. You put all that in. This app is supposed to magically tell you the best way for you to do it that day. I seriously hope it's not going zigzag all over the park. I don't think they would do that. I do that enough as it is. If you want to make it easier for me, and I don't zigzag all the time, but once I get my stuff done, I tend to zigzag a little because of wait times and things like that. But I hope it's a streamlined thing like they say it's going to be. So if you put in Jungle Cruise, I hope it puts you there, because you know first thing in the morning, go left.
Yep.
So if first thing in the morning, if they tell me like Space Mountain versus Jungle Cruise, Space Mountain early in the morning is still packed, don't put me there first. I hope it's all true. And we'll see when it comes out.
That's the key. We're guessing right now. We're hoping. This is the Christmas wish list for the new app. You know, if the app isn't gonna float for me, I've been going long enough where all you gotta do is give me the updated wait times and I'll navigate it myself.
True, true. And you can, I mean, this is, you're still gonna have the My Disney Experience app.
Yep.
This is an add-on to it. So hopefully it does integrate at some point. Supposedly they're going to tell you, you know, it's more flexible. You're going to have more fun throughout the day. They're really pushing it. Of course they are. They don't want it to fail. Any business would do the same thing. I get it. So that being said, we're going to get into the part that I think is, that's not a terrible, terrible thing. I don't mind the Genie app itself. I think what I've been reading on the Facebook pages, the comment sections of the stories that everybody's putting up, like the Disney insiders, is the Genie Plus aspect of the app. So this is where you're going to shell out a little bit more money.
Yep.
Okay. So for Walt Disney World, well, let's get, before I say that, you're going to get into, this is where your fast passes are coming in. So they changed it to Lightning Lane. There's a Lightning Lane. For you to use the Lightning Lane, you have to pay $15 a day per person at Walt Disney World, $20 a day per person at Disneyland. This affords you the ability to wake up in the morning and pick one Lightning Lane to start your day. When you're done with that lightning lane, you can now pick another lightning lane. It's unlimited throughout the day, but one at a time.
But what's the butt for? I'm waiting for it. What's the butt for?
But
There's always a butt.
it's not for every ride.
Yep, that's
Okay.
right.
So are there popular rides? Yes. Haunted Mansion, Big Thunder, Space Mountain, I believe.
Course.
You're getting Millennium Falcon now with a lightning lane, which I
Okay.
think is a good thing.
Yeah.
However, certain rides are not included in this. Seven Dwarves, which for some reason is a very popular ride. I
I'm
enjoy
sure when,
it, but I'm
yeah.
not going to wait 4 hours for the damn thing.
I'm sure when Tron is done, it won't be in there as well.
Oh yeah, I don't think so. So those two rides in California at Radiator Springs is not included in that. And in both parks, Rise of the Resistance, which is probably the most popular ride in both parks, is not included. You will have to pay extra per ride per person if you want to jump ahead.
Yeah.
Okay. Rise of the Resistance will still have its virtual queue, but you can pay to skip that. I don't know how they're going to work that in because that virtual queue literally fills up in 30 seconds.
Yeah, exactly.
7 a.m., it's done. You just got lightning fingers, hope for the best. I'm not a fan of that at all because I think if you're spending 6 grand, 8 grand as a family to go, you got to have something a little bit more. Everybody knows there's no guarantee of any ride at Disney, but to spend that much money for fans of Star Wars to travel that far and not get in just because it's a lottery, a little
Yeah.
ridiculous. So,
I think now, by now, they should have it a little more structured. You know what I mean? Where it's been out long enough now where they should be able to manage it. To, I'm not saying like Flight of Passage used to have like 6 hour wait times. All right. I think they should be able to manage it a little better as far as, all right. If you get up at 4 o'clock in the morning, you can bid on between 7 and 9 for your boarding pass. You know what I mean? And then when it gets closer, we're going to open up 9:01 to 10:01 for boarding pass. You know what I mean? It should be something like that. You should have
yeah.
that, and it should alert on your phone when the bidding is open.
And I'm not sure exactly what time these lightning passes can be picked at? Is it at park opening? Is it before rope drop when the gates are open? You can get in. Are you just have to be in the park? Can you be at a resort? That I don't know. I didn't find information on that.
Well, they didn't go into those details, and I was looking as well. But I mean, seriously, for my fast pass, because we bank left, I hit Jungle Cruise, Pirates of the Caribbean, Big Thunder, Splash Mountain, all before 10 o'clock, and I walk on those rides.
Yeah.
Everybody seems to rush to Fantasyland and Tomorrowland to get Seven Dwarfs and Space Mountain.
Yeah, I nope, fast pass those. Yeah. Really want them.
Exactly. Even though we fast passed Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, we still had to wait 30 minutes.
Wow. I haven't had to wait that long.
We just jumped the 3-hour standby queue.
Yeah. Still a little bit of a wait.
Yeah, it was still a little bit of wait. And to be honest, yes, the ride is smooth. I love the carts that sway. The animatronics with the holographics are amazing. But the ride is like 30 seconds.
Yeah. Well, the other thing that kind of put me off about this is I was watching this 15-minute video that Disney themselves put out, and the guy was talking about it, cast members talking about it, and he said the thing that I caught in there was you're still going to have the standby entrances, of course. You're going to have the lightning lane. You're still going to have standby at most attractions, which means some attractions – may not even have a standby line. You have to do a virtual queue or pay. And that has already come out that Remy's Adventure, the Ratatouille ride.
Yeah.
There's no standby. It's a queue or you pay.
Which it kind of, hear me out now. It kind of could be a good thing for the virtual queue. And here's why. Sometimes, let's say Peter Pan's Flight and Small World. Two rides that for some reason generate a huge line. But they're so in close comparison when the lines are, you know, they come out into the walkways. So it bottlenecks that traffic real bad there. So a virtual queue for those two rides would be a real good thing. Because it would alleviate all that, you know what I mean? All that congestion. So some virtual queues will be a good thing. But if it's just, okay, we're taking, let's just say, Peter Pan. We're taking care of, the standby line is gone. You can only use the lightning, you know, the lightning lane. Why do I have to pay to get on Peter Pan's flight?
True.
That's my concern.
Well, I think with the Rise of the Resistance, they did the virtual queue. In a way, they kind of had to. It hasn't run smoothly at all. It's never run smooth all the time. Okay. I don't expect it to. But more times than not, I've heard horror stories. Okay.
Yes.
I think they looked at that and they say, oh, well, that was a success. Let's use it for the Ratatouille ride. And I think when you're going to have these rides, and because people have that FOMO thing, a fear of missing out, I have to get on the Ratatouille ride. I have to be at the Marvel Adventure thing right when it opens. I have to be the first to do everything. Those attitudes, that's the reason why have these things. And it's what's driving it. I get it. Who doesn't want to be the first one on the ride? Who doesn't want to say, oh, I rode that before everybody else. I was there the first month. Yeah, it's cool. I get it. But I think it's kind of ruining it for people down the road. Because we're at 2 years at Galaxy's Edge in California, and it's still the same thing. And Walt Disney World Hollywood Studios is worse getting into the queue. It's just, the horror stories are ridiculous. But it's a lottery, and we're not paying for a lottery. I don't spend $100 on lottery tickets, I'm not going to spend $100 to ad get into admission into a park just to maybe get on a ride. Now,
Exactly.
that's where if you have the money, you're going to pay. At that point, I guess I can budget maybe, I'm thinking it's going to be $10 to get
Yeah.
onto Resistance per person.
Yeah,
So,
that
all right.
I see it, but there's no guarantee you're going to get in the virtual queue
Well,
unless it space blocks. Like, okay, today we're going to do 500 virtual queues using the Lightning Express, whatever it's called, and then the rest are all going to be standby. That's the only thing. But then again, I pay for it. I'm in that holding pattern, and then boop up, you're number 501. You're out the door. Do I get my money back?
for anything that has the virtual queue, there's no standby lane.
Right.
So don't have to worry about that. But I think it's brilliant on their part because you have a queue, you know you're not you might not get in. For me, I'll be like for one day, I'll be like 30, 40 extra bucks, whatever much money I got. Three to
Yeah.
six people in my party, we're paying it. We'll skip breakfast and we're gonna go.
Yep.
All right.
That's exactly what's going to happen.
Then I'll do that. But Disney looks at that as a success.
And it's really not a success, and here's why. Okay. Like you said, I'm going to skip breakfast. All right. You and I both are Star Wars fans. We both are dying to build our lightsaber. Well, you know what? We may now not have the budget for the lightsabers as well. Or, wow, there's a really good t-shirt there. I gotta pay the extra to get on this ride. What's more important, getting on the ride? Buying a t-shirt. What's more important, getting on a ride? Going to buy something to eat. Now you're
Right.
starting to kind of make your guess balance what's more important. And that's how it should not be. It
No.
should you shouldn't have to it's kind of like what we talked about in certain restaurants. You have certain restaurants where the food and the experience is way up here, and you have the food and the experience way down here. There shouldn't have to be this. You know what I mean? It should be, okay, I'm paying to get in the park. Okay. I get it. You want to go skip ahead, so you want to pay extra, but I should not have to balance the experience on the ride, the experience at a diner, or buying stuff with my family. I shouldn't have to balance that experience. And
Correct.
that's what it's
And
coming down to.
yes. So, family of four, okay. If you want to do the Lightning Lane, the Genie Plus, okay. Just the Genie Plus. Now, Genie Plus, let me just add on what else you get, okay. So, with that, you're getting the Lightning Lane, augmented pictures. So, you're going to have like an augmented reality. You can take pictures of Mickey Mouse climbing over your shoulder. I could do that in Snapchat for free right now. Okay, maybe they'll take that away, but I could do it for free. And there's also something with the if unlimited downloads of your photo magic pass that day. All right, that really doesn't concern me because I'll get them later.
Yeah, exactly. If you get the memory maker, you get that already.
Yeah, so I don't get that part of it. You also have also in the app, I want to say they do have a virtual assistant that you can, but you have that anyway in the apps that you can talk to a Disney cast member. So, but here's the thing. For family of four, $15 a day, that's $60 a day. Say you want to do that for every day for a 5-day trip. I'm thinking 5 days is about average for everybody. That's $300 extra. Okay. Now you tack on the fact that you have to pay for your Magic Express again. And I forget, how much was that?
I forget. It's been a while since we've gone over
Yeah.
that. Because right now, if you remember, the train, Universal realizes they screwed up and didn't get in on it. So now they're trying to stop the train from being built because they want now in on it. Although they had the opportunity and they passed on it,
Yeah,
they
well.
realized they screwed up. So now they're taking it to court to try and get them to build a station for Universal, which is going to in turn screw all the guests.
Right. And we still don't know how exactly how it's working, where you can get dropped off, things like that. Here's the things that have been taken away in the last year or so. Okay. So think about that $300. Now, Magic Bands. If you want one, you got to pay for one. They're not cheap.
Okay. Depending on what you want, anywhere from $20 to $70.
Just say $20. So yeah. Family of four, that's $80. You're up to $380.
I do have a thought though. If instead of spending the $40 on the picturesque Magic Bands, just buy if you have to buy one, buy the plain one. Go on eBay. They have pins. Use the pins. Decorate them yourself, guys.
I never cared about it. I got a solid color one when they sent them out to us for free. It wasn't free. It was included in my price, okay?
I still paid my $6,000.
Yeah. I never looked at that as they were giving me a Magic Band. I paid for that with my admission, okay, people?
It's my roommate.
Yeah, exactly. It did everything. So that's another $80. Magic hours were taken away, except for like deluxe resorts that, well, we pay more, we should have more. Well, you gave that to all your guests as a nice perk. So basically, to me, you're cheapening my admission price. You still have to pay for parking. So that's what, $15 a day? So that's another, that's money. You're looking at all these things that they're taking away and having you do another $400 to $500 that you now have to budget for.
Yep.
Well, I'm sorry, that now takes away from my merchandise spending, number one. I don't care about the food aspect because I'll do the dining plan, but right. It's the merchandise. Now I can't buy that little trinket, whatever I want, a pin. That's what I have enough anxiety about budgeting my merchandise anyway. Now it's going to be like, well, do I want this pin or that pin? It really comes down to that. When it comes down to the average person who is the backbone of America saying, should I get this pin or this pin? You really have to reevaluate what you're charging us for. Okay. Now, I saw a great quote from somebody on a Facebook page. I don't remember the person's name, and I wouldn't say their full name here anyway. But they were talking about, hey, I can afford the deluxe resort. I can afford these new changes. But that doesn't mean that everybody else can. And it doesn't mean that everybody else should be shut out. That was like the gist of this woman's post. And this woman said, yes, it is a luxury. But there's nothing luxurious about being nickeled and dimed. So even people who are paying for a deluxe recognize that even they are being nickeled and dimed. Yeah. Yes, they can afford it. They're going to pay it. But really, how much further are you going to push everybody before they say,
enough?
So, yeah. I don't foresee myself doing Genie Plus every day that I'm there. I honestly, I couldn't afford it. And I don't like, I'm going to be a little gripey right now, and I'll sound like a Ken, whatever you want to call me. Ken. Karen, whatever. I don't know. Karen, Ken, Barbie, whatever. $80 is $80. $300 is $300. And to the people that say, don't like it, don't go. That's not the point. No. To the people that say, don't tell me it was this is not what Walt would have wanted. I saw someone say, what are you using a Ouija board to talk to Walt? Do you know what he wanted? Yeah, I think we do know what he wanted. Families to go to the park, right?
Yeah, he was pretty clear when he said he wanted families to spend time together and enjoy the moment together. That's pretty clear what he wants.
And, I mean, Nevin and I are just two average dudes. And, you know, we're not we're not scraping to get by. No. But at all, but
well, we're not sitting on piles of money where I'm swimming in it like Scrooge McDuck.
Right. You know, hey, I understand. You worked hard. You earned your money. We all do. And you make a little bit more than me. Then go ahead. Go to the deluxe resorts. Does that mean you deserve more than me?
Nope.
I don't know. I bust my hump at work. That's why magic hours ticked off a lot of people to take that away.
Although I found out something. Remember how I mentioned about renting for DVC points and things like that? I have found out from doing research, the DVC points as of right now are not going up in price, which is a good thing. And if you rent them, the Magic Band will recognize that you're at a deluxe, which means you get the magic hours.
That's great.
So there is work around. I mean, because right now, if I stayed at Old Key West is the first ever DVC resort. It is kind of far away from the parks. You got to take the bus to get there. But if you stay at Old Key West for 7 days, it's cheaper to rent the points than stay at a value resort right now.
That's awesome.
So you can stay at a deluxe resort cheaper than a value and get your magic hours. So guys, yes, right now they are nickeling and diming. A lot of companies are.
Sure.
A lot of companies are nickeling and diming right now. But do some extra research and look around. You might be able to find some deals. Do I agree with Josh? Do I think this is bad mojo, bad juju? Yes, I do. But I get it. They, for the last year and a half, they lost millions of dollars, and maybe in billions for all I know. Let's face it, no movies. Everything's on Disney Plus. You know what I mean? So there's a big chunk of change gone. You had parks closed. You had the cruise lines not working. Lots and lots of money being lost. So I get it. My wife keeps reminding me, you know, do we really want to go for our 50th anniversary or 25th anniversary? I'm like, yeah, we want to go. Hopefully by then a lot of this is going to be ironed out.
I would think so.
But you never know. I mean, yeah. What was it? In one day in Florida at a school district, 5,500 kids had to be quarantined.
Yep.
Who knows?
Exactly.
Who knows how this is going to go? So, guys.
The end of the world. We don't know. The other thing I wanted to, along with nickel and diming us, okay, is they're putting the responsibility on the guest to do things. So everything's going to a phone.
Right.
Okay. Phones don't last all day, people. Batteries drain. I think I talked about this before in one of our early episodes. I don't want to carry power banks around. I like to carry as the least amount of stuff as possible.
Right.
So now I'm thinking with all this stuff that you got to do. So you have all the stuff on this app that, oh, I can take a picture of myself with Mickey hanging over my shoulder. There'll be an audio experience that, oh, while I'm in line, I can listen to like the history of the ride, or there's Mickey walking with me down the street and all the photos. You're using it for your tickets, your room key. Everything, this thing is going to drain. Plus, Florida's hot. Not everybody's phone can take the heat, okay? No. Even iPhones don't take the heat, okay? You're going to be charging this thing nonstop all day.
That's where you buy those banks and throughout you the do, day.
You buy the banks, but – and there are a lot better banks than the last time I went. Yes, yeah. I understand. But still, more expense that way. If your phone – not everybody's going to afford a new phone every year.
No.
I don't understand that. Most people hang on to a phone for 2 years, I think. Unless you do have that FOMO feeling, you got to have the newest phone. I don't need that. And I buy a phone. It works. I can make phone calls, surf the web, do everything I need to do. I can buy tickets and go to Hershey Park or our local Dorney Park. I can do that. No problem. Use their apps. No problem. I think that you're going to see people running around. I got to charge my phone. And what if your power bank dies? You don't have another one. You're going to be sitting there wasting time charging your phone somewhere.
Yeah.
There's too much responsibility moved off and put on us. That's what I don't like. It's you're responsible for everything. I'm paying so I do know I have to be responsible for certain things. But that band was the best thing I thought they ever did.
Yeah.
It didn't run out of a battery. The thing lasts for years. You could reuse the one that you had. Maybe if Disney was a little bit smarter, they said, hey, you know what? We sent you a Magic Band last year. Would you mind using it again? Yep. Think of the environment, things like that. That's all you had to do. I bet you people would have said, even if half the people said, oh, yeah, sure. Or I have one that I bought for $25. I want to use that one again.
Right.
So extra expenses keep piling up, no matter what. I think Disney will realize maybe their merch is going to go down. Food sales might go down. Even for now, for me, I go for 9 days. One day is pretty much a travel-free day.
Yep.
Not anymore. I don't know if I could spend 2 days at each park, which I could do, honestly. 2 days at each park, especially now. Now it's going to be probably a 5-day trip. So you just lost 4 days out of me. 3.5.
Yeah, for me, I'm still doing my normal 7. But we may not hit Disney Springs, you know what I mean, as much. They're going to notice, some revenue may go up, but they're going to notice a sharp decline in merch and food. It's not going to balance itself out. That's why I would love to know what focus groups, who they had in there that said this would be a good thing. I'm curious.
Now, to compare to other, I'm not going to say theme parks, but amusement parks, okay? I went to Hershey Park last week when I was on vacation. I put up some pictures. It's an okay park. It's nothing like Disney. It's not a theme park. They have little Hershey Kiss characters running around. You can read my review on the Facebook page. I'm not going to get into it here. But they do have a fast pass option. It is ridiculous. For me and my kid, now we got a deal where everybody pays kids' prices. This is back in June. So it was, I don't know, 30, 35, 40 bucks less than normal to get in.
Okay.
But that's great. For me to get their fast passes, so the two of us went for, I think, like 120 bucks. I think it was about that, which is pretty good.
Yeah, it's good.
For us to get the fast pass would have been over $300.
See, that's ridiculous.
And even if you did their fast passes, there's an unlimited one, and then there's one where you get one entrance per their big rides. And that was like over $200. So it didn't pay at all to do that. I think Cedar Point has it. I know Great Adventure has them. All these, our local Dorney Park has one. And it is very expensive. It's more than $15 a day. But you get everything right away. You don't have to make that reservation. You just go to that fast pass line and you walk in.
Yeah.
Now, maybe they want you to make the reservation to control crowds. It is Disney. It's bigger. I get that to a point. But certain rides, I don't think you should have to. Small World, do you really need to make a reservation for that? No. There's so many rides out there. Like, I don't know. Is there going to be a lightning lane for Figment? That's what I want to know. So, well, I think we've kind of griped enough about this.
I don't think we I think we meet valid concerns.
Sure.
Like you said, we're two everyday dads. Budgeting is our thing. We don't go to Disney often. We don't have that type of money where we're there all the time. Do I think this is going to definitely widen the distance of when I'm going to be going? Yes. This will definitely widen that distance. And who knows? That may be the grand scheme of it all, is to, you know, have people come less so to help with crowds. That may be the case.
You know, I'm not the one that – I never wanted to go to Disney every year.
No.
I think to me that it's too much. I liked going every 2 years. It was something to look forward to. Mm-hmm. I could save enough money and I can have a great time. Now I'm going on 3, possibly 4 years before I'm going to go. And yes, I've been saving money along the way, but saving money definitely was a lot easier. Yeah. Last time I went, you know, I'm also like just thinking now, like, yeah, I'm saving now still, but they keep adding and adding and adding. How much more you get to save. It's like college tuition almost. So, you know, is it doable? Yes. I agree 100%. But
does it make it right? That's the question.
Yeah. So let's see how it does run.
Yeah.
For a couple months. I'm sure they're going to hopefully tweak it if they need to. And do the right thing. That's all that we can ask, is that Disney does do the right thing. I don't know how it affects annual pass holders. Will they get backed out for things like they do? I don't know. But maybe it will control the crowds enough that, oh, the standby line instead of an hour is now half an hour on things.
Yeah,
who knows? And I think that's maybe their thing. If enough people pay for the lightning passes, the standby lanes will go down.
And the good thing is it's still cheaper than the Disney Paris one.
That is true, because that's per ride. So.
Yeah, exactly. So it is cheaper. My thing is, if it's still in effect when me and Karina go, I'll probably pay for the lightning lane. It's just going to be me and Karina, just the two of us. The second day when we go to Magic Kingdom, probably I won't then.
Yeah, I could see doing it for one day at each park, but not 2 days at each park. Or if you have, like for me, I would definitely do it for Hollywood Studios, so I can get on Rise, get onto the Millennium Falcon. Yep. I like Rock and Roller Coaster, things like that.
Not a fan.
I know you're not, but.
They don't get roller coasters. Give me Tower of Terror every day. I'll ride that more than Rock and Roller Coaster.
Oh, I love Tower of Terror.
Yeah.
I
just think we need more details instead of a broad overview. We need more details. I need to look at, and here comes the analytics side of me. I need to look down, break it down for myself. Okay, is this going to be financially beneficial?
Yeah. Bottom line.
Yeah.
So
it's my money. I want to use it the way I want to use it. Does this work out for my best interest?
Absolutely. All righty. Well, that's our 50th show. So, let us know what you think. Seriously, let us know what you think. Good, bad, indifferent. You disagree with us. You agree with us. Whatever. Drop a comment below. Drop a comment on our Facebook page, on our Instagram page. Look for Magical Main Street Dads. We pop up. Twitter at Magic Main ST Dads. Let us know what you think about it. It is what it is. Is it going to stop me from going? No. If they keep doing more and more and more, I'd seriously consider postponing it again, because I have to save more. That's what's going to happen. So with that, you got anything else, Nev?
Nothing good, bro.
All right, dude. That we're out. Stay safe, be good, and have a magical day.
See you later.
Well, Alibaba had them 40 thieves. Sherry's already had 1,000 tales. But master, you in luck, cause up your sleeves, you got a brand of magic never fails. You got some power in your corner now. Heavy ammunition in your camp. You got some punch, pizzazz. Your blue and house, all you gotta do is rub that lamp. And I'll say, Mr. Aladdin, sir, what will your pleasure be?